Do you take anything of these training videos, reaction? I don't know if you even knew he had the match. What do you respect at all when it comes to Pat's acumen in the ring?
So, again, I got to start off with this because I've never been someone who lies. He is an amazing athlete.
Sure.
Without question. Seriously. I mean, if I can't go in there and say, this guy's not even an athlete, that's me lying to you. Of course he's an athlete. But the training video, I mean, it showed me, yeah, he can do a flip. All right. I think he's definitely going to try to flip on me. What is that supposed to freak me out or scare me? I've been doing this for over 12 years. I've wrestled and competed against every single style of guy, every size, in every country, won every championship. Pat McAfee in pro wrestling has done nothing. And the beautiful thing is I'm right now I'm on the verge of hitting my prime. I just came off the longest reigning NXT championship run of all time. So people think that's like a downtime for me. Of course I want to get the NXT championship back, but I'm still in that championship mentality. I'm still in that focused, that nothing but 100% go mindset going forward. And Pat is in the middle of that. So was the training video impressive? Yeah, impressive in the sense of his athletic ability. Was it impressive to Adam Cole, the 12-year veteran who's been doing this for a really long time? Don't make me laugh, man.
And Adam, you know, you've had a lot of impressive moments. You stacked up a lot of accolades in your career, which you're kind of hitting on there. And one big moment for you was last year on SmackDown. You defeated Daniel Bryan, and Pat McAfee was on commentary for that match. But my question is, did it irk you that then Pat got into the ring with the entire NXT roster to celebrate? Did you feel like maybe he was just kind of leeching off the popularity of NXT at the time?
So I'm so, so happy that you asked that question, because in the moment, I didn't even really realize it. You know, I had just beat Daniel Bryan, you know, a guy that I idolize, one of the greatest to ever do it. On my debut in the main event of SmackDown. That whole day was so insane. So in that moment, I didn't even think about Pat being in there. But about a week later, I remember watching that close with Triple H in there and all of us in there. And I remember seeing Pat in that ring and it making me sick to my stomach. Like, once again, here is a guy who has done absolutely nothing to help the growth, the advancement, the invasion of NXT for that month leading up to Survivor Series. And he's standing in there like he belongs. And that's the other thing too. If you watch him, it's not like he's standing there and he knows he shouldn't be in there. He's standing there like he owns the freaking ring. It's disgusting. And he's always been this way. From the very beginning, he has walked into NXT, whether he's doing commentary, whether he's commentating on SmackDown, it doesn't matter. Whether he's standing in the ring with the other NXT talent, the ones who are the driving force behind NXT, he's standing there like he belongs, and he does not belong. Doesn't belong at all. And I'm going to prove that once again at TakeOver 30.